this is home, and my parents came from Puerto Rico in the 50s. So I'm gonna let Angie introduce herself, and then I'll talk a little bit, and then she'll share her story.
So my name's Angela. I am also a resident of Logan Square, yay. I've lived in Humboldt Park and Logan Square pretty much most of my life. And, you know, I want to thank Mike and Elastic Arts for having us here. And it looks like you guys are fundraising here for this cause. I will tell you, I'll share a little story about me. My grandmother, right, the pillar of the family, came to the United States at a very young age. She worked here her entire life. As a matter of fact, she worked close to 30 years at Bally's factory. I'm not sure if you guys have, are familiar with Bally's, but I'm pretty sure you're familiar with Pac-Man, right? And pinball machines. That was the business that, you know, she was helping, you know, waking up 5 o'clock in the morning every day working. She worked over 30 years, and her dream was always to retire and move to her native land, the beautiful island of Puerto Rico. Well, what can I tell you? She finally, you know, moved into her dream home out there, probably lived about a good 15 years in that home, and where do things stand now? Well, you know what, very sadly, it's most of the island is just really, you just can't live there, right? You have no water, you have no food, you have no supplies. A lot of homes you can't even get into because the roads are gone, and here we are, right? An island that's a U.S. Territory that's in total shambles. And so my family rescued her and her sister, which are up there in age. My grandmother's 88, and brought them back to Chicago. And how sad is that, right? You work your entire life, you want to finally retire in that dream home in your native land, and this is the way you say goodbye, right? So grandma's staying, she's not gonna go. she's 88, she's still a firecracker, but you know, it's I will tell you that most of the people that live on the island are her age. They're up there in age, and a lot of these people are still in their home because they don't have family that could go out there, that could afford $1,000 to travel out there to bring them back. So again, that's our side of the story. My grandmother was one of the lucky ones. She has us, and we all pitched in together to bring her back. And she's happy to be with us, but she's not happy to be in her real home. So again, thank you for your time. You guys rock. You guys were rocking it here a few minutes ago. Thanks again, and thank you for allowing me this time to share my story.
So the interesting thing that's happened as a result of the hurricane, both Irma and Maria back to back, is that all of a sudden people get to learn about Puerto Rico whether they want to or not. You turn on the news, or pick up a newspaper, hear starting the radio, it's in the news, right? We all of a sudden, this little island that's 100 miles long and 35 miles wide exists, and people are starting to realize that there is a connection to the United States, that people in Puerto Rico, Puerto Ricans, are U.S. citizens. You know, Puerto Rico is a fancy word for a colony, is a commonwealth of of the United States. Technically, the United States can't have a colony, it's against the Constitution. So they find a different word for it. And so there's a lot of tension there, and there's a lot of identity issues there, because we're a very strong culture, but connected to the United States. And in a way that's unhealthy, in a way that the people in Puerto Rico cannot vote for the president, but they can't make many decisions for themselves. The U.S. president and Congress make decisions for them. things like the Jones Act, which, you know, it creates a tax for goods to be transported that's twice as much than if stuff were to come from a different country. And so there's a lot of injustices on the island, and I hope that you take the time to learn and be critical about what you're hearing on the media, because the media doesn't always tell you everything, or it can be biased themselves. And you know, one story I can tell you is that a friend of mine was down there for Irma. He's a retired electrician. He went down to help his uncle patch up his house. And so he's there, and then he gets caught in Maria. And he says there were 16 people, and like Angela said, a lot of the elderly who have weaker houses, they rounded up people from the area, and they huddled together for a day. And they said, imagine a jet plane. I guess you guys can imagine it, because that's kind of like what the music sounded like. you might have enjoyed Maria. But you may have not enjoyed the aftermath, which is, at this time, 23 days of 85% of the island doesn't have electricity, and 40% doesn't have water. That's 23 days later. And you know, we're not sure when everybody's gonna have electricity. And the island has about 3.4 million. Chicago has 2.7. So imagine all of Chicago and a little bit of the edge, you know, for maybe 2 weeks, no water, no electricity. You know, my family's used to not having electricity for like a week. They're used to hurricanes, but you know, this was a massive hurricane. The night before the hurricane, I talked to my family, and they said, yeah, we just spent $200 on gas for 9 days during Irma, because they lost power during Irma. That was $200 that they spent so that they can have a generator going. So we really, really appreciate what you're doing tonight. Whatever you're contributing really makes a difference. Pay attention. Ask critical questions, hold your elected officials accountable at all levels, because Puerto Rico is part of the United States, and they're human beings and they have needs. And again, thank you and have a good time.
Lucy, Angie, thank you so much for coming out for today's event. The Logan Parent Neighborhood Association, Lucy and Angie, thanks for amazing. Oh man, more people showed up. Stick around. Tell your friends to come. Just want to give up again for you guys. You guys are great. We're gonna have Blacker Face up next.
15 minutes.
Yeah, stick around. Donate again.